This video is sponsored by epariksha.in.
First of all, what was this timing, I say?
Sorry.
First of all, we parked my
bedtime.
No, I'm in the teacher. I'm like, okay, these girls are doing makeup, and I'm like the wrong person on the second because I still wear zero makeup, and you know this about me. And the has Riti called me on the wrong show by any chance? Because this is not my cup of tea at all.
Look at me. I'm sitting in the robe.
You have this whole 60s girl going on. Like, I'm a housewife and I wear bands and do. Okay, so continue.
Okay. I'm putting this up. So, yeah. You can go ahead and explain.
So, see, the thing is that first, our background is around the Save Shakti. And I started a couple of years ago when I broke out about the casting couch and I spoke about that issue. And as soon as that happened, I started Save Shakti as a petition, actually. What the petition was about was that there are actually only 5 Mahila courts in Tamil Nadu, because it's supposed to be 32 courts in 32 districts, right? But it's not there. And I was petitioning saying that we have to have a Mahila court in every district, right? Because we have only 5. Because if you have a Mahila court, it's a women's court where your cases get, you know, fast-tracked and women abuse and stuff like that can go. So started off as a petition and went up to the central government and I met the law minister. And I told him and I showed him these things. And he said, yes, there is a budget, but it's just not been implemented. In fact, 333 crores were kept aside for Mahila courts, but it just wasn't implemented throughout the country. That is a sad state.
And
that
Tamil Nadu had until then, no one had even asked about it.
No one cared about, you know, asking or implementing anything. So it was really sad. And, you know, that's when the whole movement started off. After that, what happened was I made Save Shakti into an NGO and made it into a trust, which raises funds and helps women who are affected by domestic violence. And we did a lot of walkathons and we did marathons. We raised funds for them and we try and help out as much as we can. In the lockdown time, Lavande, what happened was that like I told you, nariya animals were all left abandoned and the street animals, yaarkume saapad kediyadu. Because all of us who are going out, there is no garbage, there is no throwing away of food, everything, the whole food chain has come to a standstill. And when we casually went for like a drive, there were a lot of animals who were just like starving. So this group called Sankalp reached out to me saying, you know, what Pedigree wants to like, you know, sponsor food. So will you be able to help us out in some way? So appadi start pannadha vandu, we started off at a very small scale. And then we said, okay, fine, let's. Because see, what happened was, ellarkum they keep saying, you're rich enough, you give money. I can't support for the rest of my life. You know how our payments work. We don't get paid. We have to say this on camera. We are the worst paid people in the world. Nobody knows it. Actors are the worst paid. We don't get paid at all.
Yeah.
So, you know, so we can't keep giving money and we also have our own families.
Especially the females.
So, you know, as much as I can, I've kind of, you know, we bought food and we've been giving. But then this has now, considering the lockdown is going to go on so long, it has to be, you know, a regular way. So what we decided was that you were saying something.
No, I was saying June 30th.
So then, we said, okay, fine. I said, okay, you can use my Save Shakti Foundation. Well, let's raise funds for the animals. And I said, romba romba enna or sadoshmana matterna. I didn't expect that many people to actually contribute. You know, that is the biggest miracle. You know, you think that people out there don't really care. But I got amounts like 5 rupees and 10 rupees and 15 rupees. It's not the amount. It's just the gesture that mattered. And we managed to raise about close. Yeah, we managed to raise close to 6.5 lakhs, Reggie, like in over 5 days.
Wow.
For animals, yeah. And I was shocked beyond belief and I was so appreciative and thankful. So that's how the whole movement started. So now we go and now obviously see Pedigree and Royal Canin can't keep giving sponsoring food because they also will go under law. So what we do is now we've taken this money. We are buying food from Pedigree and Royal Canin and we're giving it to the animals. So we made it like, and there are lovely, lovely people. Like Sankalp Beautiful World and there's Arun and a lot of people from different animal welfare people who are coordinating and made my house the distribution center. So they pick up food from my house. All over the city. That's the beauty of it. everybody from one area comes home, picks up the food bags and goes and does it for their all the city people. So we try to cover as much as we can.
So no, so is there a, like a you know, like an idea of how much you'll have done till now, like the number of dogs?
See, or, the thing is, see, like in per area, there's close to almost 25 to 30 dogs. So you do the math. So just imagine all over the city, how many dogs will be there? And you know, on an everyday basis, lunch and dinner, not just one meal a day. It's lunch and dinner. So we've and also we're feeding cattle, we're feeding cats, you know. So there are so, like that day I went to feed a dog pedigree, but the cow was actually asking for the pedigree. So just imagine their state of affairs. Yeah, that one is like, man. I'm like, okay, maybe if you want to eat pedigree, I can't be. So we quickly ran back home, got us some vegetables, and then fed a vegetable. So, you know, it's really, really sad that there's, right now there's no choice. So people are just eating whatever you give them. You know, I mean, what are people, I mean, animals, but you know what I mean. Yeah. You know, people also the same gadi only. So what to do?
Yeah,
so you know, whatever is there.
Yeah.
So you know, it's like beggars can't be choosers kind of a situation right now. Yeah.
For everyone, this is the this is the account. Where to send what to.
Yeah.
All the details are there.
Yes.
And yeah. And you were, and like JLo was adopted, right?
Yes. We adopted her.
Yeah. That's something I think we should all take a little.
See, the thing is that I think it lots into this whole concept of buying a breed, of buying like, you know, a fancy dog, which is fine. See, each one is allowed to have what they want. But the idea is, she is an American bully who came up for an adoption, actually. Yeah, so she's American. And also, I have an Indian at home who was rescued with three legs. He met with an accident and he had to amputate one of his legs. So I have a three-legged dog at home. I have another fellow called me. Yeah, she's adopted him, so he's in our house. So we have like three dogs already in the house, and like I think I don't remember ever a time that I've not had a dog in my life. They've always been adopted, picked up from the street, picked up from the road. In fact, Uruvati Vande, we've smuggled a small little puppy from the beach and not told my mother. And we came out of the house, and my sister and me are like, Mommy, we got this puppy. We want to keep it. She's like, what?
But eventually, that's the same thing I did every time.
We end up saying mummy, she'll first throw up of us, and eventually she'll only end up taking care of the dog she'll end up taking care of it. The story of our lives is about this with my mother and the dogs, and she's actually the rock star of this whole project. She's been going out every day tirelessly, feeding the animals, making sure they get the animals. In fact, now the Safe Shakti is also extended into migrant workers. So we're feeding migrant workers before they get on the trains. So that also is happening now. So every day, mom's going to Egmore station and sending off like about 300 migrant workers were given food. So yeah, now some migrant workers have got into the place now. So mom's going every day to the stations, and almost like every day about 150 to 300 migrant workers being given water and food because they're going on the train journeys. Like they don't know where they're going to get off or you know, how long they're going to get back to their hometowns. So yeah, we're actually Safe Shakti started off as a female-oriented trust, but then it's just like, you know, in difficult times, you just have to like reach out to how many people you can.
It's good, and I don't know how many people are doing it just for animals. And another friend of mine also does it for, you know, migrant workers and animals, but not too many for animals.
No, Raji, the sad part of animals is that they can't ask. That's the sad part, you know, because see, even people, somewhere you can open your mouth and say, I'm hungry. For them, they don't
also at a time like this, you're thinking, I myself don't have, what am I going to go give the animal, you know? But even if it's just a few bones from whatever you've eaten, even if it's like three bone pieces, throw it for your cat.
They'll eat happily. It doesn't matter. You just have to give whatever you want to throw in the dustbin, just give it to them, they will eat it. Like that day I saw a cat eating garbage in the garbage truck, you know, it was like, you see, very sad thing. And there's a cutie pie who's been abandoned outside my house. So this Blackie, anybody opens the car door, jumps into the car and sits down, thinking it's going to go back home. And we don't know whose dog it is. A black dog. A small little, like, probably about 2.5 months. So somebody's come and abandoned it with a collar. And so she thinks every time you jump into someone's car, that someone's going to take her back home. So it's very sad. I'm saying, don't get animals and then abandon them. You know, that's something which is very, very, like, wrong, I think. Yeah. It's just
a friend
really
of
sad.
Mine also got an abandoned pug recently, you know. They just abandoned him on the highway and left. And it's so sad, you know. It's really, really sad to see people do
this. The amount of dogs that are being saved right now during this lockdown is crazy. Like the organization I'm working with, they've abandoned pugs and Alsatians because they're old. And there are so many dogs being abandoned. I'm like, why get them and then abandon them? They don't have, like, and they're so used to their house. They're also like a family member, no? How can you just, like, leave them and, you know, go? Yeah. In fact, when I saw the picture of the migrants carrying that dog, it was so touching. When I saw the picture of the migrants carrying the dog and taking them home. That's what, see, that's what real love is. You don't say, you know, you just, like, stop and stuff.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Okay.
That's that. I'm all trying. I'm going to try and show J-Lo since you asked about her. Hold on. Let me just see if J-Lo's there. Okay, so hold on. I'm going to show you how she is. There she is.
And the Poochko, so cute. So cute.
Yes.
Poochko.
She is fully sleepy, but yeah. Hello, all your fans want to say hi to you.
Say hi, baby.
Oh,
look at her. She's like, leave me alone.
Yeah. Thank you, darling. Thanks for having me.
Yes, and thank you so
much.
Darling.
Enjoy your night. Bye.